used to be when people talked about the end of the world, we locked them up or laughed them off. Sometimes both. But we never took them seriously. Maybe we should have. But I'm getting ahead of myself. Better to start at the beginning with the abduction of Desmond Miles, my son. This boy had no ambition, no direction, no plans for the future. What he did have was a heritage, one he chose to deny. It nearly cost him his life. He was captured and imprisoned. Those who took him believed he could help them find something. The apple. One of several artifacts we call pieces of Eden. Bits of ancient technology scattered across the globe. Some hidden, some found, all of them dangerous. Most are held by a single group, the same group that now had Desmond. You know them as Abstergo Industries. We know them as the Templars, as the enemy. We've been fighting them for thousands of years. Even longer if you believe the stories of their origins. I do. After all, I've seen the truth. That's the beauty and the horror of the Animus. A device that allows us to enter and experience the lives of our ancestors. It holds the power to change everything, to show us history the way it really happened. Up until its creation, to the victor went the spoils, went the truth. We're trying to fix that, to free minds and bodies both. But there's only so much that we can do, and the Templars have the upper hand these days. But something larger than the Assassins and Templars is approaching, bigger than all of us. And if we can't find a way to stop it, these next few weeks will probably be our last, everyone's last. In the end, it all comes down to him, to Desmond. Through the Animus, he discovered his heritage, explored the lives of his ancestors, and uncovered their secrets. When that was done, he trained. He used another ancestor to provide decades of experience in the span of a few days. It worked. We think. We hope. Soon, though, soon we'll know. That ominous date fast approaches, December 21st, 2012. None of us knows what it'll bring, only that this is where they want us to be. When it does. They've been guiding us in their own fractured, frustrating way. These voices from the first civilization, the ones who came before, a precursor race of immense power and uncertain motives. They're the ones who made the pieces of Eden. This is where they've led him, and through him, us. He stands at the entrance to this long-lost place, armed with the knowledge of Altair and the abilities of Ezio. He holds in his hands the Apple of Eden, and we stand at his side, ready to support him however we can. His name is Desmond Miles, and he has brought us to the end. Here. Let's go. In another moment, down went Alice after it, never once considering how in the world she was to get out again.
You must find the key.
Son? Sir?
Here we go again.
Desmond?
Do you hear us?
Yeah. What happened?
The temple triggered a bleeding effect. You collapsed and entered into a fugue state.
So naturally, you dropped me into the Animus instead of, I don't know, making sure I was okay?
You weren't in any danger. Besides, the temple appeared to be communicating with you, and I didn't want to risk severing the connection. At least not until we knew what it wanted.
Right. Of course.
Son, I...
No, it's fine. I get it. And I know what I'm looking for, by the way. It's a key. Just no idea where it is, though. I guess that's why she triggered the bleeding effect.
She?
Juno, Dad. She's talking to me.
Okay, Desmond. While you were, visiting Constantinople, we picked up a software update for the Animus. I'd like to run a couple of quick tests, make sure there aren't any major issues.
All right. What do you need me to do?
We'll start simple. Walk to the marker over there. Okay, Desmond. Let's practice climbing on these objects. run your way through this little obstacle course. That's a constraint. These are optional objectives that raise your synchronization rate. All right, Desmond, follow the on-screen instructions and kill the two Templars. All you have to do here is jump the gap. Synchronization levels look good now. We should be able to build the world. Time to find out what the temple wants from you.
Sir? Sir? Everything all right, sir?
Yes, fine. I'm just preoccupied, that's all.
Don't forget your invitation. Master Birch will be meeting you inside.
Thank you.
Where shall I retrieve you once you're done?
Front of the Opera House. And be quick about it. Don't expect to be here long.
I'll bring her round at once.
Invitation, please. Shall I take your coat, sir?
Ladies and gentlemen, you are requested to kindly find your seats.
Good evening, sir. This way, please.
My apologies.
Evening, Haytham.
Reginald?
I can't tell you how happy I was to hear they'd mounted this revival. Gay's best work by far. Have you seen it before?
Once. My father brought me here as a child. Though I remember little of it. I don't suppose tonight will afford me the luxury of a proper viewing either.
No, I'm afraid it won't. On to business, then. Do you see him?
Be seated in one of the boxes above.
The stairs are watched. You'll need to find another way up.
A lawyer is an honest employment. So is mine.
I already have.
Me too. He acts in a double capacity. Both against boats and for them. For 'tis but fitting that we should protect and encourage cheats, since we live by them.
Sir, Black Maul, that set word of trial, comes on in the afternoon.
1,000 pardons. So sorry. My apologies.
As the wench is very active and industrious, you may satisfy her that I'll soften the evidence.
Upon the case, sir, is found guilty.
A lazy dog. When I took him the time before, I told him what he would come to if he did not mend his hand. This is death without reprieve. I may mention a book. Poor Tom Gag. £40. Let Betty Sly know I'll save her from the transportation, so I can get more by her staying in.
Betty has brought more goods into our lofty year than any five of the gang. And in truth, it is a pity to lose so good a customer.
If none of the gang take her off, she may, in the common course of business, live at 12 months longer. I love to let women escape. A good sportsman always thinks the end of our prisoner's life was the breed the game depends on.
Ha!
Besides, here.
Drop a bloom in your cheek.
Jeremy's really burning up the boards tonight.
He's a marvel.
Haytham, you should have come to me. We would have found another way.
Yes, but then you would have known. For what it's worth, I'm sorry.
As am I.
Calm, please!
Over there! That's the one that's...
That man there! Seize him!
Whatever has happened?
A man was killed,
but
in the upper balcony.
I've done no wrong!
Oh,
I search him. Any weapons?
I beg your pardon, madam. Did you notice anyone...
No, no, please!
Peace, friends! There is no danger!
Let us through!
Sir,
try to remember...
There is no danger! Order! We must have order!
It happened right at that balcony.
What are those men doing in there?
I'm staying where it's safe.
Order! We must have order!
Move! Move!
Hey.
Imbecile!
Where are you going?
And how was the opera?
Rather dull, truth be told.
Shall we be off, then?
Aye. To Fleet and Bride.
By your command.
Fascinating. Gentlemen, I hold in my hand a key. And if this book is to be believed, it will open the doors of a storehouse built by those who came before.
Ah, yes. Those who ruled, reigned, and vanished from the world. Do we know what it is that would be held within?
It could contain certain knowledge. Perhaps a weapon, or something as yet unknown, unfathomable in its construction and purpose. It could be any of these things, or none of them. They are still an enigma, these precursors. But of one thing I am certain. Whatever waits behind those doors shall prove a great boon to us all.
Or our enemies, should they find it first.
They won't. You've seen to that.
I assume you know where this storehouse is?
Ah, Mr. Harrison.
Gentlemen.
How fare your calculations?
I believe the site lies somewhere within this region.
That's a lot of ground to cover.
My apologies. Were that I could be more accurate.
That's all right. It suffices for a start. And that is why we've called you here, Master Kenway. We'd like for you to travel to America, locate the storehouse, and take possession of its contents.
I'm yours to command, although a job of this magnitude will require more than just myself.
Of course. Upon this paper are the names of 5 men sympathetic to our cause. Each is also uniquely suited to aid you in your endeavor. With them at your side, you will want for nothing.
Well, then I'd best be on my way.
I knew our faith in you was not misplaced. We've booked you passage to Boston. Your ship leaves at dawn. Go forth, Haytham, and bring honor to us all.